Kadri gets the puck. Morgan Riley takes over and up the boards to Patrick Marleau. Got Kadri breaking through the middle as he gets by Carlson. Marleau with Marner shoots. He scores. Another pretty play right from the breakout, and Mitch Marner's got a pair. It's 3-0 Toronto.
Well, Jim, you mentioned a little bit back on their heels are the Senators. They're going to have a goalie change here as Condon's going to come in. But this starts 180 feet away from the goaltender. A set play off the faceoff, a hard wrap. Carlson gets caught standing still. Little tap back there by Kadri, and pretty darn good execution. From the tap back to the cross seam pass by Marleau, and no chance at all for Anderson trying to slide across and get his glove there. And that is a short night for Craig Anderson. 10 shots, 3 goals.
Goalie change is brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, the best in replacement parts. And the replacement goaltender has been very ill. Mike Condon was getting another night off because he's trying to come back from the flu, but he's into this game.
Well, back the other way. That shot is in. Michael Haley makes it 3-0 Florida. And we're going to get a goaltending change. Wow, the Rangers need something here, and Alain Vigneault is sending Andre Pavlik into the game.
Yeah, the Rangers have had chances, and Reimer, James Reimer, has really played well.
I think it fumbles off the stick right there and rolls off, and it rolls right onto the forehand of Milan Lucic, who does a nice job of not just one timing it. He stops it. He has a quick look to see if he's got somebody at Carey's back door for a tap-in, but then he just lets it rip. And the goaltending change is going to happen for the Montreal Canadiens. They're going to take Carey Price out of here and bring the Emmy in at 4-0 and 17:36 to go. And you mentioned how special Carey Price is on Saturday night here, especially at the Bell Center. It has not been an oil painting for Carey Price in this one thus far.
It has not. To continue the painting analogy, if it's been anything, it's been a Jackson Pollock, and that is abstract and not focused. It's been ugly. Wow.
To center, Komarov cleared the puck. Kadri rushes onto it. Trying to go around Trouba, knocked off stride, centering. Marleau shoots, he scores!
It's almost like he's got the invisible cloak on. Nobody goes near him. On the stick, off the stick, stick side against Mason, and just like that, 5-0. Here's the view from the goaltender. Very small, maybe a little too far to the right side of the net, and Marleau's quick release makes it 5-0 and ends the first night for Mason as a Winnipeg Jet.
And let the second guessing begin already on night number one. Connor Hellebuck knows exactly what that's all about. He got pulled 8 times last season from the net. Backed up most of the time by Michael Hutchison, but Steve Mason.
Back to Matthew Pekka. Quick shot off the post, they score! That one sneaks through on a snapshot by Conacher from a sharp angle. And it's 5-4 Tampa Bay. Michael Ferland flips it back to Gaudreau, but it's intercepted by Kunitz, and in he comes now. Kunitz cuts to the middle. Threw it out front. Stamkos scores! Steven Stamkos goes top shelf and makes it 6-4 Tampa Bay.
And here is the goaltender change that we're wondering about after.
The other way again, it's Eakin centering, but hops over the stick of Perron, perhaps an active stick, got it. McNabb's shot, big rebound, and Neal scores!
I think Rick Tocchet's got to pull his goalie. Antti Raanta, this moment's been too big for him. Johnny McLean, the assistant coach, is talking to Louis Domingue right now. They're going to make a goaltending change. Rather than utilize your timeout, do this to take the crowd out of it. Good move by Tocchet, but now he's got to get his players to start managing the puck. This has been an omnipresent performance by Vegas. They've been so strong in the forecheck. Their speed's been really apparent. David Perron, nice feed, puts it out front, and then James Big Deal Neal sticks it to the back of the net. 2 goals in game 1, 1 goal in game 2, and in game 3, Alex, he's got another one.
About a week ago, There was uncertainty if he would even dress for Vegas as Louis Domingue comes off the bench for Arizona.
Beamsdyke for Hanifin, and away they go. Cross ice pass of beauty. Here's Victor Rask for the front, Elias Lindholm. In and in, where it counts. In on Rene and by him. 4-0 Carolina, Victor Rask.
The puck bounced. And that's what beat Pecorine. We'll see if Peter Laviolette makes a goaltending change, but at this point, let's just celebrate and enjoy. It's in a ring, and boy, what a bounce it takes, and it hits the top of Rene's blocker side pad and then nicks the inside of his blocker and into the net. So, now I'll say the common thread is on all four goals, get bodies to the areas you have to score, get your sticks free in those areas, and then when in doubt, get pucks there too.
Well, that one is just luck and a bounce that eludes Rene. He's done. He's had a great season.
He's the one who was able to keep it out. Tomas Tatar is the other guy with 7 power play goals. He's not on the ice. There's a goal. A slap shot tip as Cromwell let it go. And it's 5-2 Detroit.
Cromwell's going to let this shot go. He's got his head up all the way. And there's the deflection up and over the glove. That's a tough play for the goaltender. That's a power play goal for the Red Wings. Yaroslav
looking for a pass and he gets it. Letestu catching up, winding and firing. Rebound, Letestu scores! Mark Letestu driving to the net, got the rebound. And the Oilers have opened up a 2-goal lead.
This is textbook. We've been talking about this for a long time because the coaches have been talking about this to their players for a long time. Use the goalie to thump the pads to pass it to your line mate. Mike Camilleri does a great job. Check out the shot to the far pad on the ice, kicked right to Mark Letestu, who knows exactly where the puck is going. He knows where the shot's going, so he can drive the net. Drives the net hard, gets the stick on the ice. The defenseman, he's got to take his man. He can't turn and find the puck, but he can't stop. Mark Letestu's got the head up, the steam. A big goal for the Edmonton Oilers. I think they might be having a look at this on the bench, but that one looked clean. But Mark Letestu in his 500th game puts the Oilers up by 2 in the second.
And gets his first even strength goal of the year.
Goalie change.
And Jimmy Howard is being replaced by Peter Mrazek.
I'm surprised actually at this, but it might be this by Jeff Blashill. And boy, Jimmy Howard just said something to Jeff Blashill as he was coming off the ice. He was not happy about getting yanked.
Justin Braun to the net. A shot and they score. Derek Stepan on only the second shot of the game ties it for Arizona. His ninth. Stepan with his ninth, and there's a tying goal right off the faceoff by Arizona. And it's 2-2 just like that. 3-2, and we still have 6 minutes to go in the first. Back comes Arizona. They score! Christian Fisher ties it right back up, and it's a wild one here at the Shark Tank on this Saturday night. 6 goals already.
Well, Aaron Dell's going to get the tap on the shoulder as he's going to replace Martin Jones on that goal. And both defensemen up, Burns and Brennan Dillon. Fisher goes off on the breakaway, pulls it on the backhand, and puts it by Martin Jones. And that was a turnover in the neutral zone, and both defensemen got themselves up in the play there. And then actually, Fisher just pulls it to the backhand, and Jones can't recover.
And Aaron Dell comes in to replace Martin Jones. Just 14:01 into the hockey game.
Oh, Petrangelo for Schwartz. Avalanche get it, they can't clear it. Chen, he scores! And it's 3-1. Chen gets number 2 tonight.
This is a hot bouncing puck for Chen, and he shows some great instincts there. Colorado's going to have a goaltending change here, and John, it wasn't because of the second goal, but it was because of the Barbashev goal.
But I gave up trying to figure it after I started adding.
Don't comments. Give up yet.
Well, I did. Here comes one of the younger guys, Schaller. Crossover move in front. He scores! What a goal by Tim Schaller! And it's 4-1.
What a play! That is absolutely fantastic by Schaller, who beats a couple of players. We're going to have a goaltending change. I'm not sure anyone could have stopped this. How about the inside move? Gets it away from Smith as he comes over to try and check it off his stick. And then up high, just underneath the crossbar. How's that for a fourth line?
Well, Tim Schaller is one of these guys for the Boston Bruins that can move up and down the lineup because of his ability to play with different players. He alters his game slightly depending on what his role is and what's asked of him. You talked about that fourth line when it's Corrali in the middle and Achari on the right. It's pretty much straight ahead. Take the body, create turnovers in the offensive zone.